Floyd is the kind of talent that needs to be challenged mentally. Mm-hmm. And maybe this next one, just to get the record, if that's what he wants to do, is okay. But I think that he's not finished after this next fight. But he needs to be challenged mentally. And I think if he fights a Kareem or even Khan is not enough for him. If Khan was unbeaten and hadn't been hurt, then it'd be a different story.
Right.
He needs somebody to challenge him. Not physically, because he's got the great tools, but mentally, he needs to be prepared to face somebody that's dangerous in his mind.
Yeah.
He seems that, 47 or 48 already? So he seems to dominate and beat everybody that he fights because he rises to whatever level he has to. And if he fights a Mayfield or a Berto, who have looked okay, but not on Floyd's level, I don't think that he'll be motivated for that. I think that 20 knockouts, no matter who you fight, even if they're waitresses, 20 knockouts, 20 knockouts in a row, I think have to say something. Obviously, he's not fighting waitresses. He's fighting guys that are rated in the top 3 or 4 in the world at the time in his division. That the bigger guys don't want to step up, that's not Gennady's fault, but we have to continue to do the things we do. But everybody, Floyd at the beginning when he was coming up, he was fighting nobody's too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Pacquiao the same way. Marvin Hagler, if you look at his record before he retired, he really didn't fight anybody until he fought Leonard and Hearns. Mm-hmm. Ray Leonard and Hearns. And the guy that gave him the most trouble was a lightweight, Roberto Duran.
He
won 15 rounds, and Marvin won a 2-point, 3-point decision. So I think that Floyd
Ward
and Andre are just talking. I think that they're drumming up business, they're simmering the pot, but
right, for the bigger payday.
Eventually, they're gonna get to the point where Gennady doesn't need them no more. At this point, they both need each other. I think that Floyd needs Gennady only because of the motivation factor that I'm talking about. Not that he needs him because he's a bigger name or anything like that, but who is Floyd going to fight that's a bigger name right now, let's just say, than Golovkin.
Exactly, that's right. What everyone's
a bigger name. Nobody's a bigger name right now than Golovkin. He's already fought Canelo. Cotto, he's looked good only because of the opposition for Golovkin. He is the biggest name that's unbeaten and that's progressing in the way that the fans are taking akin to him. And
a Mexican fan base.
He's got a great fan base.
Yeah.
He's got the biggest numbers or the largest numbers on HBO and on attendance. We sold out the StubHub 3 times. They put additional bleachers. He sold out what they set up the forum for, which is 12,000. I think it's 12,400 or something like that.
Yeah.
So on each coast, he's doing very well. Mm-hmm. I don't see anybody else at Floyd, unless it's Klitschko, but that's a heavy form, I think. I don't think there's anybody in that. And the other thing is, Golovkin's willing to go down to 154.
Yeah.
It's not like somebody said the other day, but Floyd's moved up 6 divisions. Yeah, but he's a junior middleweight champion.
Yeah.
He beat a junior middleweight. So if we're willing to go down to junior middleweight, it's the division that he fights in. Same as Golovkin asking Cotto to fight at 160.
Yeah, exactly.
Cotto is the middleweight champion. Mm-hmm. And it's not necessarily that he's after Cotto, he's after the belt. He's after the WBC belt.
Right.
But things will shake out. Carl Froch was a possibility about a month ago when he started talking all that smack, but he quieted down real quick. Now they're talking again. Hopefully that fight in the future gets made. But right now we're waiting for the opportunity before the end of the year. And I honestly don't know who it's going to be, Tom. Tom is dealing with everybody, trying to find a fight for him, so we'll know soon.
You know, and then they say, oh, he's fought nobodies, but even early in his career, he fought guys like Kasim Alma, you know. If you explain to the people that was a very difficult fight for Golovkin, you know, there was a lot of issues going into that fight. A lot of people haven't seen that performance of Golovkin. They think he's unbeatable, but he's had his issues coming up, too. He's
had
learned.
His issues.
He's learned.
And like in this game, there's always something that happens along the way where you have to deal with some issues. He dealt with those issues. He beat Auma, and we were hoping back then that fight would make him seem vulnerable.
Yeah.
As you saw in the Monroe fight after the second round when he knocked him down.
Yeah.
He himself made himself look vulnerable. Made himself look like he's hittable.
Yeah.
Hoping in his mind that he understands the situation that he's 33 years old, so he needs a big fight. Mm-hmm. So hoping that somebody would say, hey, yeah, maybe he is hittable. Maybe I can knock him out. Everybody seems to say they want to knock him out, even Floyd.
Yeah.
But they're not stepping up to the plate. So it's hard to, it's hard to, for me as a coach to have a guy that says, I want to fight somebody and not say, you know what, that's the guy I want to fight. And let's make a deal, whichever way it happens, that's the guy I want to fight. It's become such a business with management and with promoters and networks and people fight with each other that the best guys don't necessarily fight the best guys.